One day, this sailor arrived at the palace of the king, and he informed the king about some stranger that arrived with several ships on the west coast of their island. So the king sent out several troops to find out about it. When the troops arrived, they found out it was a white guy from a country called Spain, which was next to Portugal. And there were a few Muslims within, but for the rest, they were just merchants sailing around. Now, the troops had experience with Portuguese merchants, also with Islamic merchants that came from Africa. So they thought this country, Spain, is next to Portugal. The sound of the language is quite similar to Portuguese. So the troops returned to the king and said, "Sir, don't worry about it. Those are just merchants coming by like always." But the wife of the king, I'm saying one of his wives, because he had multiple, one of his wives told him, "Dear, I have a bad feeling about this captain that came over here." And then the king said, "What are you talking about, woman?" And the wife said, "Normally when merchants come, they come with one ship and the whole group, and they lodge with us, or they lodge on the islands when they arrive. These men don't lodge. It is if they come to inspect on us." And then the king said, "Dear, you are too involved with politics. This is my case here. I deal with it." But not only one of the concubines of the king was alarmed, many people throughout the island, those many people were just a very tiny minority, but still were many, we noticed that this is weird. Why do we have this captain from a country called Spain? We never heard about that country before. We know of Portugal because Portuguese people come here from time to time. But why is this country called Spain suddenly showing interest in us? And why is this guy who calls himself Cristobal Colón or Columbus, why is he showing interest in this island? So one of the Taino people, a small guy, he was very short, he felt that danger was coming. And he told his relatives that he was about to move to another island. Then his relatives left him and said, "Which island are you going to?" He told them, "If I don't go to an island, I will go to the Mayan kingdom, to the place that's called the place of many waters, or Guatemala. I'll go over there because I feel that something bad's about to happen to us." And he was not the only one thinking like that. Well, the next years, this Cristobal Colón, he returned to the island. He brought more ships with him, but this time the ships had soldiers. And the Taino king had to submit to him as governor. He changed the name of the island to Hispaniola. And he enforced a rule in the name of the king of Spain. So now the Taino king became a servant in his own country. Not only that, the people resisted and they were shot, they were killed. Eventually, some of the traitors began to kill their own. So it led to one big civil war. A lot of people committed suicide because they didn't want their daughters to be sold as slaves, because those Spaniards kidnapped a lot of the young girls and women to be sold to slave markets. Much of them wanted the small children for sex slaves. So many families began to kill themselves because they don't want the children to have a bad future. Within 20 years, the population of the island went from 3 million to only 20,000. And the next 40 years, Columbus was gone a long time by now. There were only a few hundred left. Now that guy 40 years earlier that told his relatives, I'm getting out of here, and we need to get out of here because things are about to get ugly. He was right. He looked at the bigger picture. He noticed that this visit of this Columbus, who carried the name of a Babylonian goddess, that it was bad news. By the way, Columbus comes from Colombia, and Colombia is another name for Semiramis, one of the goddesses of Babylon, and who was also the wife of Nimrod. So this Taino Indian, we knew about religion, we knew about witchcraft, realized, hold on a minute, this is bad news that this guy carries the name of Semiramis. Why is he doing that? Yet he claims to follow the Lord. He claims to follow the Christ, but he carries the name of a Babylonian goddess. So he didn't trust Columbus. That guy, 40 years later, was well alive on mainland Central America, while the Spanish colonized what they named Hispaniola. Now, this was a parable. Now, the colonization of Hispaniola, which today is divided between the Republic of Haiti and the Dominican Republic, that really happened. Okay? The voyage of Columbus or the voyages happened also. The decrease of the Taino population also happened. And all the horrors that came along with it, all the traumas that came along with it. So I made this parable based on an historic event. Now, what am I teaching you with this parable? That Taino Indian, the small guy, that was not taken seriously by his peers, he saw the truth. He noticed that something was wrong, and he alerted others, but others wanted to remain asleep. They wanted to be left alone. Well, they got what they wanted. They were left alone. They were left alone onto their own destruction. Because if those people would have paid attention, it was only that small Taino guy. It were more Taino people that said something is wrong here. If the population just listened and really paid attention, they would have realized this is bad. But at least they would have been prepared if an invasion came. But they were not prepared for an invasion. And because of that, they were shocked. And in the shock, they operated in a very self-destructive manner, which made it very easy for the Spanish colonizers to kind of exterminate them. Okay? So they complied with their own extermination. Why? They didn't look at the bigger picture. They were not alert. They were not aware. Now this happened. Now, when the Spanish went to the Aztec Empire, there were other smaller kingdoms besides the Aztec Empire. They did it differently. They complied with the Spanish in exchange for privileges with the Spanish. So they knew we couldn't stop the Spanish because they had their king, and their king sends them over here to do their thing, but we will use their presence over here for advantage. And that's how the Spanish used Indian compliance to get rid of the Aztec emperor. And that's how they established the viceroyalty of New Spain. The capital of the Aztec Empire that turned into Mexico City, or Ciudad de Mexico. Mexico was another name for the Aztec Empire, or Mexica, whatever you prefer. And the remainder of the population that remains there, also complied with the Spanish, and the Spanish modernized their nation. And the nation of Mexico still exists till this day. Well, it's not exactly the same way as it was then, but the name Mexico and also the relevance of it is still here till this day. The Taino people, they're gone. Their heritage has been destroyed completely. Why? They didn't look at the bigger picture. Now, why am I using this example of the Taino Indians and of the Mexica Indians and those around them? Because those on the mainland heard what happened, because there were Taino people that fled to mainland Central America when all these horrors were happening, and those refugees reported everything. Okay? Now, the Indians on the mainland, their leaders, they look at the bigger picture, realize for us to remain in existence, we can't fight those troops, which are more stronger than us. We need to use our own strength against them. And eventually, those native nations became the main instrument of Spain in the New World. And it even led after a while that Spain went bankrupt because they had to maintain their colonies in the Americas. So the native nations were now draining Spain. And they were now important in maintaining Spain, even though it was Spain that came took them over. It happened in history that Spain became dependent on their colonies to remain alive, kind of. And who were the elites in the colonies? The descendants of those native elites. So, why did I give you this history lesson? Why did I give you also this parable, in this historic parable? Is to show you that looking at the bigger picture is life-saving. But just like with those Taino Indians, many people were asleep or they just wanted to be left alone through the daily thing. They didn't look at the bigger picture, they didn't notice the red flags. That's how a lot of people are today. And that's why Satan can go around as a roaring lion, seeking whom he can devour, and he devours a lot of people here and there. And why can Satan devour so many people? Or better said, why can the beast devour them? Because it's the beast that rules the darkness. Why can the beast just go around freely destroying people? It's because folks don't look at the bigger picture. They don't want to be alert. They want to be left alone. They are cowards. I'm telling you, don't be a coward. Don't be a coward. Look, well, what it comes down to is the following. As a believer, I'm not talking to everyone now, as a believer, as someone that agrees with Christ, you have power over the whole camp of the enemy. So it shouldn't be that the enemy gets any advantage of you. Okay? It shouldn't be that you're complaining and crying because the enemy is making his heart on you. It should be the enemy and those in the enemy's camp should mourn and complain and become hysterical because you're making it hard on them. That's how it ought to be. But here's the thing. In the parable I just gave unto you, that guy, that small Taino guy, he was alert. He thought, someone cannot come in the name of the Savior, yet they have a last name that refers to a Babylonian goddess, that refers to Semiramis. That's not right. How many are alert as a tiny Taino Indian? How many? In pagan Christianity, most are not alert, most are not aware. We know that. I mean, there are so many abominable things happening in pagan Christianity that shouldn't even happen. I mean, a lot of the things that happen in pagan Christianity, if you would take it out of pagan Christianity and put it in a secular environment, the secular people would say, not going to happen here. It goes too far. This goes way too far. The secular folks tend to be more suspicious when something is inconsistent, while pagan Christians just go along completely most of the time. Look, I'm telling you, if anyone comes in the name of Christ, but their expression is the expression of Babylon, I'm telling you, look out. And with expression of Babylon, I'm not talking about how someone dresses. I'm talking about how someone speaks, about vocabulary and all that. I'm talking about the fruits that they carry. Do they bring life and abundance where they go? Or are they tricking people into self-destruction? Look at the bigger picture. Do not be like the Taino nation. Be at peace.